In society today, you seldom hear anyone speak of the progress of their country or society in terms of their physical well-being, state of happiness, trust, or social stability. Rather, the measures are presented to us through economic abstractions. We have the gross domestic product, the consumer price index, the value of the stock market, rates of inflation, and so on. But does this tell us anything of real value as to the quality of people's lives? No, all these measures have to do with the money sequence itself and nothing more. For example, the gross domestic product of a country is a measure of the value of goods and services sold. This measure is claimed to correlate to the standard of living of a country's people. In the United States, healthcare accounted for over 17% of GDP in 2009, amounting to over $2.5 trillion spent, hence creating a positive effect on this economic measure. And based on this logic, it would be even better for the US economy if healthcare services increased more so, perhaps to $3 trillion or $5 trillion, since that would create more growth, more jobs, and hence boasted by economists as a rise in their country's standard of living. But wait a minute, what do healthcare services actually represent? Well, sick and dying people. That's right, the more unhealthy people there are in America, the better the economy. Now, that is not an exaggeration or a cynical perspective. In fact, if we step back far enough, you will realize that the GDP not only doesn't reflect real public or social health on any tangible level, it is, in fact, mostly a measure of industrial inefficiency and social degradation. And the more you see it rise, the worse things are becoming with respect to personal, social, and environmental integrity.
You have to create problems to create profit. There is no profit under the current paradigm in saving lives, putting balance on this planet, having justice and peace or anything else. There's just no profit there. There's an old saying, pass a law, create a business, whether you're creating a business for a lawyer or whatever. So, crime does create business, just like destruction creates business in Haiti. We have now roughly 2 million people incarcerated in this country, and of those, many of them are in prisons run by private corporations, Corrections Corporation of America, Wackenhut, who trade their stock on Wall Street based upon how many people are in jail. Now, that's sickness, but that is a reflection of what this economic paradigm calls for.